This week on printables, the training print is something I think will be really useful and one that I'd be printing myself for sure, even if it wasn't trending. I'm a big fan of Gridfinity and we have a storage box based on that platform. Let's print. There's some notes to take into account with this print. Even if you've seen this one, there's a new parametric file available. So I created a 4x4 storage box and did it in grey, white and orange, which was a colour theme I saw on one of the remixes for this. The parametric version also has a handle on the side, which I liked, but a little bit more about that later. If you have a 3D printer and haven't seen Gridfinity system, I don't know where you've been, but I've got some links in the description for good collections of things to print. It's a great open source platform designed and released for free by Zach Friedman and a perfect example of licensing designs for the benefit of everyone. This print takes that standardized system and puts it into what seems to be a fairly rugged, stackable case. This was a long print. The hinges, handle and locks were only a couple of hours altogether, but I did those at 0.1 layer height for better detail. The lid and base was draft mode at 0.28 layer height, and I upped the speed and temp, as you need to keep both in balance. Compared to normal, there's a little bit of very fine stringing. It was still about a 15 hour print for the base and 8 hours for the lid. For assembly, there's slotting in the hinges, which have a little tab on them, and that holds them surprisingly well. The latches slide down into the slots on either side, and the fit again is very good, like the hinges. For the handle, I had some M4 20mm bolts that slotted in fine. They bit into the slightly smaller hole on the outside of the handle, both sides really well. If I had shorter bolts, I'd have used those so they didn't stick out, and if you really wanted to, you could put a nut on the outside, but really those bolts aren't going anywhere. At this size, at 4 units wide, the handle is a little bit small, and it's one of the things that Pred, the author of this model, has noted. I'll probably be using this for small bits and pieces and wouldn't be very heavy load, so I don't need more than 2 fingers in there, and it's just big enough for me. I haven't printed a label yet because I'm not 100% sure what I'll be putting in there, but probably some small drill bits. I tested with a bunch of bins I had already in one of my drawers, including one with small nails in it, and it held them all in place. If you do get really fine stringing, an easy way to get rid of that is with a small blowtorch. It makes them curl up and you can scrape it off, but they normally fall off pretty quick if it's something that gets used a lot. That's it for another week. If you like this and want to see what top trending print we do every week, please comment, subscribe, hit the bell for notifications.